on key, and off beat.
Support comes from Austin Girls Choir, now enrolling girls ages 8 to 14 for a fun music-filled day camp June 5th through the 9th, focusing on jazz, pop, and light classical. Details plus additional opportunities at girlschoir.com.
Support for KMFA comes from Apple Music Classical, a new app designed for the nuances of classical music. Apple Music Classical is included with select Apple Music subscriptions and available now in the App Store.
We'll start this hour with a symphony by Mozart, a symphony number 33 in B-flat major, Kirchhoff 319, which he wrote in 1779. It was the second symphony he wrote after his fateful trip to Mannheim and Paris, wherein his mother had passed away while accompanying him. Here it is.
That Travis County has won an award from the National Association of Counties for our remote work program. We submitted the award and we had to make the case for how it improved efficiency and how it improved operations, and we have a great story to tell in that regard. We've been able to document an increase in productivity, a significant improvement in employee morale. And if you're a large employer, those are the two holy grails. You're always trying to figure out, how do we increase productivity? How do we improve employee morale? And I'm here to tell you a remote work program is a big part of that answer. We've also accomplished some things that we didn't realize would be among the many benefits of this program. We've dramatically reduced our greenhouse gas emissions. The second largest source of our greenhouse gas emissions at the county was our employee commute. So we've reduced that by almost 30%. We've saved money on our utilities. We don't have to heat and cool and light our buildings as much. So we've also contributed to some reduction in congestion, because our employees aren't on the road at rush hour racing to get to and from work. So there are so many benefits across the board, and I think that's why Travis County is being recognized with this national award. And I would encourage other large employers to take a look at the success we're having with this program. And I'm going to hand it over to my great colleague, Jeff Trevelyan, who serves with me on the Travis County Commissioner's Court, for some comments.
Well, first of all, I want to say it is wonderful to sit next to Brigid Shea and to talk about ideas that are going to help our workforce. When she talked to me for the first time about 75% of our staff having the opportunity to work from home, I said 3 out of 4? Eligible staff. But we talked about staff that does not have to meet face-to-face with the community. But we also talked about standing up the offices of our personnel at home, making sure that they didn't have to drive in an hour to work and an hour from work. How would that help our productivity? It has helped our productivity dramatically, but more importantly, it has helped the quality of life of workers. We have got to think of our internal staff as our internal customers, just as we look at our constituents as our external customers. If we can make it easier to serve, if we can provide the tools that are necessary to serve, if we can do the things that make this a great workplace, we should be bought into that proposition. And at the Commissioner's Court, that's a proposition that we have bought into. It is always nice to get national recognition, but it's more important to have our workers' union stand with us and help us brainstorm about ideas that are going to make it better for everybody, because we know that if we focus on our employees and do the things that are necessary to make sure they have a better quality of life, that's going to translate directly to the type of service that's given to our constituents. So we want to make sure that we are listening. I think in this instance we were. The idea has proven to be solid, not only from a performance standpoint, but also the way that the environment is impacted as well. So it is always good, when I used to work with John Sharp, for us to say a government ought to serve the people, but it also ought to serve the staff as well. So I think that this has been a project that has hit a home run, and we want to keep working with our employees, with our unions, with our community, to talk about better ways to continue to serve our entire community. So thank you for coming out today, and we appreciate you being here.
Thank you. Commissioner Gomez, do you want to make a few comments?
Yes. Well, this is great. I'm very proud that we're getting this kind of recognition for the things that we do here in Travis County, especially for our employees and their families. Obviously, I think it should be clear to everybody that an employee who is comfortable about his family her family being taken care of can come to work and give the hours necessary here to serve the people of Travis County. And that way, we kind of interact well with the people that we represent. And then we behave well, too, with our colleagues and our employees. And so it kind of makes for a very happy family. Indeed, and it's all about public service, obviously, and helping each other with the issues that concern employees, and there are several, but it's good to know that they can tell us, maybe through their representatives, you know, that of the things that they need, and then we need to listen. We need to hear what they are saying and then take the proper action to make sure that we are taking care of each other. And then we all take care of the public that we serve. So I'm very proud of this award, and congratulations to the Travis County Commissioner's Court for this kind of action. Thank you.
We're going to hear next from Ben Sudeby. He's the president of the AFSCME Local, which is the employees organization union, and he is also an employee at Travis County who takes advantage of the remote work program. So he's going to talk a little bit about that.
Thank you. Yes, on behalf of all our members at AFSCME 1624, I want to thank the National Association of Counties for giving this award to Travis County for recognizing the efforts that went into this. I thank the Commissioner's Court, both current and the sponsors who sponsored this item and really put in the work to make a deliberative process, to look at data, to put in the work, to analyze, you know, who is able to do their work from a remote location. It really gave an opportunity to show good use of public funds and public resources, because we're, having people work and commute less. And I've heard from people whose jobs require them to work on site who have said, you know, I don't have to fight for as much parking. I'm not circling the parking lot when I come back from my lunch, because people who don't need to be at an office can work from home or from a remote work site. And it was the process of analyzing and taking time to really look at what the data showed. And we were surprised, like was mentioned, those who are eligible for them, the majority are taking advantage of it. And this is something that our members are unified on. Even those whose jobs do require being on site part of the time or all the time, they also see benefits from having people who are happy support staff on the other side of that chat, right, responding in good time because they're being taken care of. So thanks again to the National Association of Counties for recognizing the hard work that Travis County did. Thanks to our elected officials. Thanks to our union staff as well and all of our members who have really supported this effort. Just a personal anecdote I experienced yesterday. Because I'm able to telework, during my lunch break, I was able to go to my 5-year-old nephew's graduation from kindergarten. As that was wrapping up, I was able to jump in the car and sit in the car while family was visiting and hop on a call, hop on I made my 2 o'clock meeting right on time. That wouldn't have been possible had we not had such effort to work remotely, have that flexibility. So I want to thank all of those who worked so hard to have Travis County be a leader on this remote work policy and implementation. So thank you.
Hello, my name is Carol Guthrie. I'm the business manager for AFSCME Local 1624. I want to take this opportunity to commend Travis County for doing the right thing and taking your time, doing the work that was necessary so that your telework proposal is one that can sustain itself throughout time. You have to do the work. And more importantly, this sends a message to all of the employees from the commissioners that they trust their workforce. You have to have trust in order to make telecommuting a thing, and Travis County has done it, and congratulations over and over again for the great job that you all do. Thank you.
And I just want to give a little bit of history on this. My former colleague, Gerald Daugherty, and I co-sponsored this item at the beginning of the pandemic. Pandemic really hit in March, and I think most of us remember everybody took their laptop and went home because we were still trying to figure out how this disease spread and whether or not it would be safe to be around other people. And we saw immediately how that solved our congestion problem overnight. And that's not a workable solution for, permanently. But we saw how much remote work could help reduce congestion. We saw a lot of other benefits from it. And it was in May, so 2 months after we started it, that Commissioner Daugherty and I brought an item to the court giving direction to staff to bring back a plan to have 75% of our eligible employees work on a permanent basis remotely. And eligible, we were really clear, eligible meant people who didn't have to physically be at work to do their job. And we also gave flexibility to the managers and supervisors and said, you decide who those people are, and you decide what you're going to need. If you need your team to be in the office once a week to really, do the teamwork, you decide that. If you want to do it twice a month, if you want to do it once a month, if you want to do it not at all, you decide that as managers and supervisors for what you need. And then the other really important piece of it, and I want to give a lot of credit to our executive managers. Paul Hoppengartner is here in the room as well, and he oversees the human relations portion, the HR work at the county. They were very thoughtful about it, and we brought in Deloitte as a consultant to work with us on what pieces we would need to put in place to have this be successful as a permanent program. And I think we see the benefits of that. We know that our recruiting to fill jobs has increased dramatically because people are looking for jobs that allow them to work remotely. So there have been so many benefits from this, and I applaud all of our staff and also this court for having the vision to do this and to do it right. So I think we're happy to take any questions.
If I could just add one thing. The other thing that I think should be noted is that Gerald is a Republican who is a business owner. And I think for a lot of the problems that we have to solve, we have to work in a bipartisan way. It can't be the Democrats on one side and the Republicans on the other side. When we talk about indigent care, health care, when we talk about mental health care, when we talk about access to training, when we talk about access to food, these are all things that party should not have anything to do with. We should be talking about how we serve our community and how we do practical things that make sense. And when you look at our productivity, this made sense. And people reached across the aisles to make sure that we did what was right for our entire workforce. Didn't matter whether you were a Democrat or a Republican, we're trying to do the right thing for people who live in this community.
Okay, Sam, do you have any questions?
There are some other employees here that work remotely. Pedro, I don't know if you want to be available to be interviewed, but Pedro's here. Also our county executive who oversees this division, but we're all happy to take any questions. Thank you all so much for coming.
Thank you.